You look so wonderful in your dress. I love your hair like that. The way it falls on the side of your neck, down your shoulders and back. We are surrounded by all of these lies, and people that talk too much. You got the kind of look in your eyes, as if no one knows anything but us. Should this be the last thing I see, I want you to know it's enough for me. Cause all that you are is all that I'll ever need. So in love, so in love, so in love, so in love. You look so beautiful in this light, your silhouette over me. The way it brings out the blue in your eyes.
And then Jenn, look the other way, Jenn, look the other way.
The voices surrounding us here, they just fade out when you take a breath. Just say
the word. Oh my God, there's a cricket.
No.
Yes.
Shut up.
Wait, what are you talking?
How could that be from outside?
It's in there.
Jiminy Cricket, that means good luck.
It's in your dress?
Yeah.
Why can't you love us enough for me? So that you are is all that I'll ever need. So in love, so in love, so in love, so in love. Ooh, me.
Oh, you're so pretty.
I know. Don't touch the makeup. Keychain.
So it has a picture in the front and then just a little.
Cause all that you are is all that I'll ever need. So in love, so in love, so in love, 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 so in love. You look so wonderful in your dress. I love your hair like that. In the moment I knew you best.
everyone, and welcome to St. Catherine of Siena Church, as we're about to witness the vows of marriage exchanged between Christopher and Jennifer on this, their wedding day. So let us begin our prayer for them this afternoon in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Christopher and Jennifer, the church shares your joy and warmly welcomes you together with your families and friends, as today, in the presence of God our Father, you establish between yourselves a lifelong partnership. May the Lord hear you on this, your joyful day. May he send you help from heaven and protect you. May he grant you your heart's desire and fulfill every one of your prayers. Let us pray. Be attentive to our prayers, O Lord, and in your kindness, pour out your grace on these, your servants, Christopher and Jennifer. They're coming together before your altar. They may be confirmed in love for one another through Christ our Lord. Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord God said, "It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a suitable partner for him." So the Lord God formed out of the ground various wild animals and various birds of the air, and he brought them to the man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called each of them would be its name. The man gave names to all the cattle, all the birds of the air, and all the wild animals, but none proved to be a suitable partner for the man. So the Lord God cast a deep sleep on the man, and while he was asleep, he took out one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. The Lord God then built up into a woman the rib that he had taken from the man. When he brought her to the man said, "This one at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall called be woman, for out of her man this one has been taken." That is why a man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and the two of them become one body. The word of the Lord.
Thanks. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul's to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts. But I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not love, I am a resounding clonk or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mystery and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind. It is not jealous, it is not pompous. It is not inflated, it is not rude. It does not seek its own interest. It is not quick-tempered, it does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. Some Pharisees approached Jesus and tested him, saying, "Is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife for any cause whatever?" He said in reply, "Have you not read that from the beginning the Creator made them male and female and said, 'For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh, so they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, man must not separate.'" The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. Well, earlier today, Jennifer and Chris, I was with a couple married 70 years. Yes. And they told me they even knew one another for years before they were married. So it's really a lifetime together. And of course, we all pray that you have that same type of lifetime together. And of course, when you get a couple married that long, question becomes right away to them, "What's your secret?" And then after the usual one-liners people want to give to make a little joke out of it, well, anyone who would know them, their secret was that they took their vows seriously. When they were married 70 years ago in the sacrament of matrimony, they realized it wasn't just a simple ceremony to mark an occasion, that they were doing something sacred. and those vows and the meaning of the words that they contain and speak to one another on their wedding day are words that are not just spoken in a church building. Maybe that's the first thing we need to point out. This afternoon, brothers and sisters, Christopher and Jennifer are not just being married in St. Catherine Church building. Because of our belief as Catholics, we say that they are being married in the person of Jesus Christ. And that's where all the authority and the power of this, and the sacredness of the words of those vows come from. Because we know by ourselves, you know, especially you figure that couple married 70 years, how many times they may have had to die to themselves. But because they reflected on the meaning of their vows and not just considered them words that they spoke to one another on the day that they were married, but because they made them the rule of their lives, when they were tempted perhaps to be selfish, not want to forgive, or always wanting one's way, they realized they were married in Christ, in whom there is no selfishness, but only selflessness. And from there arises the power of true love, authentic love. And you know as well as I today, brothers and sisters, that word love is mocked the way it's used today. It conveys only what someone wants or is pleased by. Very rarely does it mean what it's meant to mean, according to the Christ and the scriptures, that one is willing to offer oneself, well, lay down one's desires and wishes for the one that is loved. Yes, Chris and Jennifer, you're not married just in a church building. You're married in the very person of Jesus Christ. And to the extent that you have a relationship with Christ that is real, authentic, that you first committed yourself to Him, that will strengthen your commitment to one another, nothing else. So on this day, surrounded by your families and friends, we pray that your marriage, whatever number of years it may be, that it be always forever. In the words that you're going to give in a few moments to each other, you express that you wish to honor, love, and respect. That word respect often gets cast aside. Very often today, people forget the meaning of respect when it comes to relationships. But the power of Christ's love, as we heard in the second reading, this love says never fails. So when you commit yourself to the love of Christ, then you're really setting for yourself the foundation for your love for one another. That your love will always be faithful, your love will always be forgiving, and your love may always be fruitful, bringing forth new life, not looking upon it as an imposition, but looking upon it as the fruit of a very special love given to you by Almighty God, so that you may one day return to Him all that He has been able to give to you. Jennifer and Christopher, step forward now. Repeat your vows to one another so that what God brings together, no one may separate. Christopher and Jennifer, you have come together into the house of the church so that in the presence of the church's minister and your community, the community of your family and friends, your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with a sacred seal. Jesus Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you. And now, through a special sacrament, He enriches and strengthens those He has already consecrated by holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so in the presence of the church, I ask you now to state your intentions. Christopher and Jennifer, have you come here to enter into the sacrament of marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly? Are you prepared as you follow the path of marriage to love, honor, and respect each other for as long as you both shall live? Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the law of Jesus Christ and His church? Since it is your intention to enter into the covenant of holy matrimony, I ask you now to join your right hands and declare your consent before God and His church. Hi, Christopher.
Hi, Christopher.
Take you, Jennifer.
Take you, Jennifer.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
Right. promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love you.
To love you.
And to honor you.
And to honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
I, Jennifer.
Thank you, Christopher.
Thank you, Christopher.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love you.
To love you.
And to honor you.
To honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
You have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. For what God has joined, men must not divide. May the Lord now bless these rings which you give to each other as the sign of your love and fidelity. Jennifer, take this ring.
Jennifer, take this ring.
As a sign of my love.
As a sign of my love.
And fidelity.
And fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Christopher, take this ring.
As a sign of my love.
As a sign of my love.
Fidelity.
And fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And in the Son. And the Holy Spirit.
Let's congratulate them.
For the church, the holy people of God, and for unity among all Christians, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all families throughout the world, and for lasting peace among all people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That these faithful Christians, Christopher and Jennifer, newly joined in holy matrimony, may always enjoy health and well-being. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For their relatives and friends, and for all who have assisted this couple, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all members of our families, and friends who have passed from this world, and for all the departed, including Thomas Sullivan, Anson and Roberta Nocera, James Nocera, Harry Harris, and Frank and Connie Spiro, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord. Now let us humbly invoke God's blessing upon Christopher and Jennifer, that in his kindness he may favor with his help those whom he has now bestowed the sacrament of matrimony. Holy Father, maker of the whole world, who created man and woman in your own image, and will that their union be crowned with your blessing, we humbly beseech you for these your servants who are joined today in the sacrament of matrimony. May your abundant blessing, Lord, come down upon Jennifer and upon Christopher, her companion for life, and may the power of your Holy Spirit set their hearts aflame from on high, so that living out together the gift of matrimony, they may adorn their family with children and enrich your church. In happiness, may they praise you, O Lord. In sorrow, may they seek you out. May they have the joy of your presence to assist them in their toil and know that you are near to comfort them at their time of need. Let them pray to you in the Holy Assembly and bear witness to you in the world. And after a happy old age, together with the circle of friends that surrounds them, may they come to your kingdom of heaven. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Now let us all pray as Christ Jesus taught us, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. The Lord be with you. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May God, the eternal Father, keep you of one heart and love for one another, that the peace of Christ may dwell in you and abide always in your home. May you be blessed in your children, have solace in your friends, and enjoy true peace with everyone. May you be witnesses in the world to God's charity, so that the afflicted and needy who have known your kindness may one day receive you thankfully into the eternal dwelling of God. And may Almighty God bless all of you who are gathered here, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Would you give the bride one more kiss? Let's congratulate Mr. and Mrs. Nocera.
Thank you. everyone, thanks a lot.
You're the getaway car, you're the line in the sand when I go too far. You're the swimming pool on an August day, and you're the perfect thing to say. And you play it coy, but it's kinda cute. Oh, when you're smiling at me, you know exactly what you do. Baby, don't pretend that you don't know it's true, 'cause you can see it when I look at you. And in this crazy life, and through these crazy times, it's you make me sing your every line, your every word, your everything. You're a carousel, you're a wishing well, and you light me up when you ring my bell. You're a mystery, you're from outer space, you're every minute of my everyday. And I can't believe that I'm your man, and I get to kiss you, baby, just because I can. Whatever comes our way, I will see it through, and you know that's what all love can do. And in this crazy life, through these crazy times, it's you make me sing your every line, your every word, your every...
First
Next up, please welcome our bride's mom, Lisa, being escorted by Uncle Ronnie and Uncle Gary. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. Keep those hands clapping for our groom's parents, Chris and Jeannie. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. All right. First up in our bridal party, our junior groomsmen. Make some noise for Nicholas. Make some noise for Christine and John. Oh, we're drinking, we're drinking. That's a new one. Bring it back to life. That's right. John, we're gonna get you some help later on for that problem you got. Next up, make some noise for Laura and Tommy. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, keep those hands clapping for Danielle and Joe. Yes. Next up, nice and loud, make some noise for Bree and Frank. Next up, clap your hands for Jenna and Domenico. Nice. And even if I could, I would. Next up, keep those hands clapping for Elizabeth and Mike. Always win. The ladies always win. Next up, we're going swimming with Caitlin and Kevin. Yes. Next up, ladies and gentlemen, two people very near and dear to our bride and groom. How about you make some noise for our maid of honor being escorted by our best man, Jessica and Eric? So on the count of three, I need a big scream. One, two, three. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the first time as husband and wife, the new Mr. and Mrs. Christopher Nocera! Come back over here, come back here, come back over here. Jennifer and Chris, come over here to the center of the dance floor. Bridal party, bridal party. You guys come too, bridal party. Come on in, bridal party, let's go. Nice and loud, come on. What? Come on. Goodness. What do we say? Ladies and gentlemen, Jennifer and Christopher got married today.
When I'm sitting in traffic some afternoon, I'm bored to death in some waiting room. I'm gonna close my eyes and picture you
fallen, and so do I. Well, I'm feeling like the luckiest man alive today. And I don't know about tomorrow. Right now the whole world feels right. And the memory of a day like today can get you through the rest of your life.
Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for your bride and groom. At their request, at this time, they would like to open up the dance floor to each and every one of you. So at this time, we invite all of our happy couples to the dance floor to join our bride and groom on their special day. So ladies and gentlemen, our dance floor is now open. Please come join us.
Too much light in this window. Don't wake me up. Only coffee, no sugar inside my cup. If I wake and you're here still, give me a kiss. I wasn't finished dreaming about your lips. Don't wake me up, don't wake me up, don't wake me up. Don't wake me up, don't wake me, don't wake me up. Don't wake me
everyone. Whoever doesn't know me, my name is Jessica. I am Jen's maid of honor, also her best friend. Almost 2 years ago, Jen and I were walking around getting lost in Spain when she said to me, when Chris proposes, which we obviously knew he was going to, that I was gonna be her maid of honor. Kind of wasn't even a choice, it's more of a command if you know Jen very well. But there was three conditions for my speech. One, can't be too sappy, because Jen hates emotion, sorry to tell you guys. Two, can't be long, because people get bored, they'll walk to the bar, which I might during my speech. And three, my most favorite of all time, don't get too drunk before. Well, Jen, I can guarantee you two things. It won't be too sappy or long. Unlike most friendships, when Jen and I first met, she could not stand me. That's a nice way of putting it, that she hated my guts. But lucky for me, that hatred quickly went away when we started joining the sorority. As we joined the sorority, we became best of friends. We realized we had so many things in common, like regretting joining the sorority. Sorry, not me. doing drive-bys late at night, which according to the police is stalking. And three, always thinking we're right. So Chris, you're gonna be wrong forever. Sorry, to start now. The day after they met, I actually met up with Jen. She said, I went to a party last night with our friend Christine Leone, and I met one of her guy friends from Franklin Square. My first question was, aren't they all married? But then my second most shocking question was, his name is Chris? But you know, as the saying goes, there's times of charm, and we're very lucky you're his charm. Everyone who knows Jen knows without a doubt she would do anything for her friends and family. She's been there for me time and time again. I can count on her for anything, whether it's at work during a tough case or for advice. For example, a few years ago, I was really upset about something and I said, Jen, what do I do? And Jen said, take a nap, because for Jen, that solves all problems. All joking aside, Jen is an amazing person. She's the most brutally honest, thoughtful, and loyal person that I know. She's a sister I've never had, and I already have one. When Chris came into her life, she's not here, so it's okay to say that. When Chris came into her life, he only made her shine brighter than she already was. She's the happiest I've ever seen her, and that's because of you. Last thing, a little piece of marriage advice, since I'm single and I really know what I'm talking about. Marriage is not always 50-50. Some days it's 80-20, but that's okay. You have to be ready to pick up the slack for your partner, because that's what marriage is, a partnership. You both push each other to be the best versions of yourself while accepting each other for who you really are. You complete each other, and that's a truly beautiful thing. The love you both share is evident every day. I'm so glad you both found each other. I wish you both nothing but love and happiness always as you start this new, beautiful chapter in both of your lives. Congratulations.
Chris and Jen planned a beautiful weekend for us up in Lake George. We went out on canoes. Chris was there to make sure my canoe didn't capsize when I reached for the ring. He was there to take pictures, videos, and ultimately be there when Ivana ultimately said yes, pop a bottle of champagne and celebrate. But then it got more serious, and Ivana and I, my beautiful wife, we said, you know what, we're gonna move to Sweden for family reasons. We said, you know what, we're gonna get married, and we're gonna get married in Serbia, of all places. Belgrade, Serbia. And I'm thinking, oh shit, no one's gonna come to this wedding. What am I gonna do? I'm gonna have no... And I said, you know what, Chris, I want you to be my best man. I'm getting married in Serbia. He's like, where's that? I said, dude, take a map, whatever. Chris was the first guy to book a flight, and he was there to me, next to my side, 105 degrees, in a suit, we're sweating. He was there for me, my best man. He gave a speech in front of 150 people, probably 149 of which didn't speak English. He killed it, and he was there for me. Subsequently, he was also there for me when we had a wedding in New York and a wedding in Stockholm. So I could say Chris is probably the first best man to ever be a best man for the same groom for three weddings to the same wife. So that meant a lot to me.
But then ultimately, it gets more serious. After the wedding in Serbia, my wife and I say, you know what, for family reasons, we're gonna move to Sweden. So, we make the decision, we're gonna move to Sweden, close to my wife's family, you know, away from the life that we built and whatever. So we moved to Stockholm, and ultimately it was very difficult. And after a few months, you know, I'm homesick. I'm saying, oh, what did I do? What's going on? Chris and Jen were the first people. They booked a flight, flew to Stockholm, spent a week, and they gave me a taste of home while I was trying to establish myself in my new home. And that meant the world to us. And then ultimately, the next progression in life, my wife and I have a baby. And again, I'm in Sweden, beautiful, love Sweden, it's a great place, love my wife. And, oh, we have a baby, and oh, you can't fly the baby for, you know, 9 months to a year until we get to Sweden, until we, you know, bring the baby to New York, and we say, oh, you know, it's upsetting, you know, I wish the baby could meet my best friend, my family. Once again, Chris and Jen said, you know what, no problem, we're gonna book a flight. They flew to Sweden, met Ella, supported my wife and I while we were, you know, first time parents. And once again, that meant the world to us. So when I look back on all this, and sorry for rambling, but the reason I bring all this up is that I think it shows the type of man that Chris is. And I think it shows the type of man that Jen's marrying, because Chris was there every step of the way for myself. From elementary school to high school to moving to the city to getting married in Serbia to moving to Sweden to having a kid. And that shows that his dedication, he will be there for you every step of the way as you go through not only marriage, hopefully one day having a child, home ownership, all the struggles that life brings. So, you know, life is difficult. It's not always easy, but having very close friends like Chris makes that journey much more easy. And they say, I'm almost done. The last thing is, they often say that you can't choose your family. You're just born, you know, you're just born into your family. But in this case, I was fortunate enough to choose my family, and I'm fortunate enough to call Chris my brother, and I love you. So, thank you, and with that, hold on. I love you, Chris. I love you, Jen. I want to invite up Mr. No Sarah. Mr. No Sarah, I'd like to invite you up here. Mrs. No Sarah, I'd like to invite you up here. I'd like you to all repeat after me.
Hail, hail, the gang's all here. What the heck do we care? What the heck do we care? Hail, hail, the gang's all here. What the heck do we care now? Oh, he's a jolly good fellow. He's a jolly good fellow. He's a jolly good fellow. Which nobody can deny. Which nobody can deny. Which nobody can deny. Which nobody can deny. Fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow. For he's a jolly good fellow. Which nobody can deny.
Love you guys. Let's have a great night.
They can't, they won't, they never will stop the party. time out there.
Yeah, I slink real fast. And now I'm doing shows in Helsinki. Finland. I know what y'all thinking that you can outthink me. But you can't, frankly. I'm out for the Benjis, Frankies. You know, just cause you ain't me, don't hate me. As a matter of fact, you should thank me. Even if you don't, you're welcome, Yankees. Digga, zigga, 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 zow. Who got the keys to the world now? Yours truly, blah, 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 blah. They can't, they don't, they never will. Stop the party.
Good time.
Yeah, when I'm at the mall, security just can't fight them all. And when I'm at the beach, I'm in a speedo trying to tan my cheeks. This is how I roll.
Friends and family, make some noise for your bride and groom.
Don't be nervous, no shoes, no shirt, and I still get service. Watch. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. I work out. Girl, look at that body.
Everyone bring it in, bring it in, bring it in. Everyone bring it in. Everyone bring it in. Everybody, everybody, bring it in closer. 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 Everybody closer. Come on. Everybody. Bring it in. We're all going to look at the camera. We're all going to look at the camera. You guys ready?
I'm sexy and I know it.
Yes.
I'm sexy and I know it. I just met you, seems like yesterday. You opened up your eyes and I recognized your face. You know that you're the one that we've been waiting for. We're gonna keep you safe. First time I held you in my arms, I knew I'd love you all the way. I tuck you in at night, another day has passed. Every week goes by a little faster than the last. It wasn't so long ago, we walked together and you held my hand. But now you're getting too big to want to, but I hope you'll always understand. Strength inside you, a strength I pray you'll never need.
but you never forget all the ones who love you in the place you left. I hope you always forgive and you never regret, and you help somebody every chance you get. Oh, you find God's grace in every mistake, and always give more than you take, but more than anything. Yeah,
ladies and gentlemen, give them a big round of applause. That's right, nicely done, nicely done.
Smile.